my dear students, in this lesson we are going to learn how to solve problems of velocity rearranging the formula. Rearranging formulas is a very simple process. Hopefully, at the end of this video, you will see that it is pretty easy. Okay, let's begin. Maybe you have seen this triangle, that it is used to reorder the variables in the velocity formula. Here you can see many triangles. I absolutely hate all of these triangles to reorder the formulas. Using one of these triangles is fine when you are given it, but if you have to learn all of the triangles, then you have to know a huge amount of information. I think that you can forget it very easily. The easier way to learn how to reorder the variables in a formula is to use a logic way supported by algebraic process. Okay, let's get started with the first problem. If a plane travels north for 2.5 hours at a velocity of 100 kilometers per hour, what distance did it travel? Okay. First, we're going to write the data. Time equals 2.5 hours. Velocity equals 100 kilometers per hour. And distance equals question mark. Now, we are going to write the formula. The formula is velocity equals distance over time. And we are going to need obtain only distance. Because of this, to do that, we are going to pass the other side of the equation time to leave the distance alone. We are going to use a little trick to do that. We are going to draw an imaginary line here. And why? Because if you want to move something from one side of the equation to the other side, you just look at the line. If the variable is in the top of the line, you have to move it to the other side of the equation in the bottom of the line and vice versa. In this case, we need to move the time to the top of the other side of the equation. As you can see here, we have the distance alone. And we are going to change the position to get the incognita in the first part of the equation. Then distance equals velocity by time. So why did we get this result? The algebraic reason. The formulas are equations or equalities. In other words, the first part of the equation is identically to the second part. Because of this, anything that we make in one side of the equation, we must do it in the other side. We have the velocity formula. Velocity equals distance over time. We need to get distance alone. Because of this, we need to move time to the other side of the equation. To do that, we are going to do a multiplication, but time in this part, because we are going to cancel these letters. But the equations are equalities. In other words, anything that you make in one side of the equation, you must do in the other side of the equation. Because of this, we need to multiply time by velocity in this part. Now, we're going to cancel time in the top part with the bottom of the... we need to cancel time, and we are going to get distance alone. And here, you need to multiply time by velocity, and you can here, and you can get here time by velocity. And voila, this is the same equation. Distance equals time by velocity. The formula is rearranged. Now we are going to continue with the next part of the problem, the substitution. Now we are in the substitution. Distance equals velocity is 100 kilometers per hour times time. In this case, time is 2.5 hours. Now, we are going to do this easy multiplication. Remember, when we are multiplying by 100, we need to move the decimal point two places. This is the first place, and this is the second place, and kilometers, because we are going to cancel these units. And finally, the result of this problem is distance equals 250 kilometers. Okay, it's very easy.
Okay, let's continue with the second problem. If a car is traveling at a velocity of 55 kilometers per hour, how long would it take for the car to travel a distance of 2000 kilometers? So the first step is to write the data. Velocity equals 55 kilometers per hour, distance equals 2000 kilometers, and time equals question mark. In this problem, we need to use the formula of velocity. Velocity equals distance over time.
In this problem, we need to get time alone. In order to do that, we are going to use the trick that we have learned in the first problem. So we will draw an imaginary line here. Now, time is in the bottom of the formula, so we need to move it to the other side on the top of the formula. In other words, time is dividing, so it must pass to the other side of the formula doing the inverse mathematical operation. So time will be multiplying by velocity. So we have to pass velocity to the bottom part in the other side of the formula. In other words, velocity is multiplying, so it passes to the other side dividing. Okay, our variable is alone. Time is an incognita here, and now the next step is make a substitution of this formula. Time equals distance. Distance is 2000 kilometers over velocity equals 55 kilometers per hour. Then we are going to use our calculator, and here we're going to write 2000 over 55 equals 36.36. And what units? Remember that here we have kilometers over one, and here we have kilometers over hours. And remember to do that, in order to do that, we're going to make a multiplication here and here. Middles times middles, one times kilometer, kilometer. And extremes times extremes, kilometers per hour, kilometers and hours here. And we're going to cancel these units, and the result is 36.36 hours. Okay, and we have our result. And that's all, guys. It was easy, right? I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.